There is a nationwide shortage of all types of housing in the United States, but there is an acute need for more affordable housing, which is generally defined as a dwelling that requires the occupant to pay no more than 30% of their monthly gross income, including utilities. Jason Doyle joins us now with more on what's being done in Oklahoma City to help improve that situation. Jason.
Rich, there are several factors contributing to Oklahoma's shortage of affordable housing. It ranges from wages not matching inflation to buy or rent a house, to more people from out of state purchasing homes.
If you find something for $100 a square foot, you better jump on it.
Cara Bowes has been in real estate for more than 20 years now and says Oklahoma lacks affordable housing right now.
If you're in the price point of under $250,000, you are going to have a struggle. I can find them, but really $200 and below is even worse. We have zero affordable housing. It's crazy.
According to research by the National Low Income Housing Coalition, Oklahoma needs more than 77,000 affordable rental homes for Oklahomans with extremely low incomes. 25% of Oklahoma renters fall into that category. That's more than 133,000 Oklahomans. Many of those who fit in the category are the working poor, disabled, or senior citizens.
We're seeing that there's a huge gap between housing wages and housing costs that's really causing people to struggle. There just simply isn't enough housing for low-income families, or low-income and extremely low-income families that are really being hit the hardest.
Sabina Brown with the Oklahoma Policy Institute researches Oklahoma's housing and says it's getting more expensive to put a roof over our heads.
Currently, to comfortably afford a two-bedroom rental in Oklahoma, you need to make about $19.91. So if you're working a minimum wage job, that's about 88 hours per week just to afford a one bedroom, and 110 hours a week to afford a two bedroom.
Finding a starter home for a person in Oklahoma looking to buy is getting more expensive too.
First house I bought for $68,000 was like, you're not even going to see that. Like $100K. It's dilapidated and in need of repair.
The starting price point is much higher these days.
Like my beginner starter home for most of my younger folks is $300K.
Jessica Casson is trying to buy a home for the first time in the Oklahoma City area.
I currently live in a one-bed apartment with my almost two-year-old dog, and she needs a space to be able to run around. And I figured my career here is good, so I might as well go ahead and go forward with getting a house.
She was not expecting the kinds of prices when she began shopping for a place to live.
It's definitely a battle. You're having to fight people for houses because there are houses that pop up on the market that are a really good price for the type of house it is. And people are jumping on that really, really fast.
Casson is glad there are programs available to help new home buyers.
I have the first-time home buyers assistance. I got a loan of $150,000 from them.
Central Oklahoma Habitat for Humanity is well known for trying to tackle the problem of affordable housing by developing neighborhoods like this one in Northwest Oklahoma City.
It's Cornerstone Creek, and it's our most ambitious project ever. And it's been very exciting for us. We purchased this property a little over 3 years ago. It was like $2.3 million to buy the property. We raised the money from the private sector, paid off the land, and now we've been developing it.
Cornerstone Creek will be developed in a couple of stages and will move in families as the houses are completed.
We're in the building phase, the first phase, which will be 91 houses. At the end of the day, when we finished all phases, there'll be 450 houses there.
Habitat for Humanity helps people with limited incomes get into these affordable homes. If they qualify for the program, the new owners have to put in at least 100 hours of work into the home as it's being built. There's also no down payment or closing costs required for the home.
There's a great need in our community for affordable housing. So we're trying to address that need one house at a time, one family at a time.
Realtor Cara Bowes says with higher interest rates, it's harder for people to qualify for a mortgage on a home.
It's harder And that's the thing. That's why we have rental. Rentals are going crazy. You'll just keep more and more, and they're putting more and more out there because those people are not getting qualified for the homes.
Also, Oklahomans are competing against home buyers from other states.
What happens is somebody comes in from California and they're like, oh my gosh, this is 250 or 300,000. Not a problem. And they're buying them.
Some of her clients who originally wanted to sell a home are now leasing them out.
Can't believe how many people will apply for a rental property. I am leasing something for $1,800 in the near the plaza, and I probably had 10 or 15 applicants in the first week. Like, it's insane. And that's $1,800 a month.
We're seeing folks like emergency medical technicians and daycare workers and teachers' assistants that don't make enough to cover a pretty modest rental home.
Brown notes the legislature did try to help with a $215 million program to develop workforce housing, but says more needs to be done to tackle the shortage.
I think to fill a gap this size, we're going to need to see more investments, and specifically investments targeted to housing for our lowest income families that we know are struggling the most. The other solution that lawmakers could look at is updating our zoning laws.
Brown says that would allow for more dwellings like garage apartments or a mother-in-law suite in the backyard. It's something Bose supports.
I think the only way to battle our affordability is to allow somebody to put, you know, grandmother or a sister or whoever in the backyard in their own individual unit.
Central Oklahoma Habitat for Humanity will hand the keys over to its first official resident to the Cornerstone Creek development next week.